What does over quota mean? And what's a quota? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's get right to the question. After I did a recovery on my computer, my email program has not worked properly as far as the inbox is concerned. I used to be able to get 700 to 800 or more emails in my inbox if I went on vacation or didn't check for a while. After the recovery, once I reached about 80 emails, it started bouncing my messages saying I was over quota. How can that be? It's getting worse now. I can have only 40 messages in my inbox and it will start bouncing my messages. Still saying I am over quota. Soon I won't get any messages. So believe it or not, being over quota has absolutely nothing to do with what's going on your PC. It's not about your PC's disk space. There may be some email configuration stuff, but it's not something that applies to your PC. Quota is something that happens on your email provider's server. So let's talk about that. What is a quota? A quota is nothing more than a limit on the amount of disk space you're allowed to use on your email provider's server. When somebody sends you email, it lands on your email provider's server and it waits there until you read it, you download it, you do something with it. That's why, over time, especially if you go on vacation, there'll be more email saved up there. Once you reach the limit of how much disk space has been allocated to your email account on your provider's server, then they start bouncing messages, usually with over quota, or also common is mailbox full. It's basically the same thing. Like I said, when your account is over quota, your email provider will be sending or may be sending bounce messages to whomever has sent you emails, and or in the run-up to hitting your quota, they may also send you warning message that you are approaching your quota. In either case, yeah, you've used up too much disk space on the email services server. So what are the solutions? Well, there are three. One is to ask your email provider for more space. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. These days, they actually tend to give you a fair amount of space to begin with. But the bottom line here is that that's probably the easiest solution if your email service supports it. The second solution is, well, don't store as much there. What that means is download and move email messages from that service. So, for example, you might have a desktop email program. You might download everything to your inbox and then maybe copy it to some local folders. The bottom line here is that in that process, the email will then be deleted from your email services server. As we'll see in a minute, your configuration matters a fair amount in how effective this will be. And finally, you know, you can always move to a different provider with a larger quota or no quota at all. I don't know of anybody with no quota, but I know that many, many email programs or email services have some fairly generous quotas in place. So let's talk about your email program settings. There are two approaches to getting your email from your email service. They're POP3 and IMAP. Normally, the old way of doing things was POP3. With POP3, by default, when you check your email on your PC, your email is downloaded. It is moved from your email services server to your machine, meaning that it's deleted from the email service, freeing up that space. It's only on your PC. The downside, of course, is it's only on your PC. Especially today, where we're using multiple devices, multiple mobile devices, that can be a little bit inconvenient. So that's where IMAP comes in. With IMAP, the email stays on your email service provider's servers. What you see on your PC and on your phone and on another PC and however many different places you're reading your email from is essentially a picture of what's on the server. So when you download, so to speak, in IMAP to read something on your PC, yeah, it's cached on your PC, but it hasn't been deleted. It's only when you delete something in an IMAP folder that it actually then gets deleted from your email services server. That's why when I said one way to free up space is to download your email, POP3 would do it. IMAP, you can do it, but when you download your email using IMAP, if it stays in the folders associated with your email account, it stays in the email account and continues to take up space on the server. However, most email programs have the ability to create what are called local folders. Those are simply folders on your PC and nowhere else. You can move email from your email accounts folders into those local folders. That then will delete the email from your account, freeing up the space on the server. Now, there are three things ultimately that end up being contributing factors. IMAP, because it saves everything on the server by default. There's a setting in POP3 that says, leave a copy of messages on the server. This was a way that people with multiple devices tried to be able to see their email from multiple places at the same time. If this setting is set, then what normally would be downloaded and removed from the server using POP3 might still be up there. So that's a setting worth checking. And the other one is actually kind of sort of out of your control other than at least knowing about it. And that is if you're suddenly getting a flood of spam, your spam folder on the server may count against your quota. In fact, I suspect it usually does. That means you might benefit from emptying that spam folder. It may be the spam folder on your PC. In other words, if you empty the spam folder in your email account that's been configured using IMAP, then that may cause the spam folder on your service to also be emptied. However, it may not. There may be a different or additional spam folder. So what I recommend you do to check this out is to use your email provider's web interface, webmail, to check the folders that are actually stored on the server and see if the spam folder isn't full of junk. So, regardless of how you got here, there are basically three things you can look into: getting more space from your existing email provider, switching to an email provider with more space, or more commonly, managing the space usage yourself. And that can be downloading email, moving it to local folders, and or checking spam and other folders on the email server itself. I hope this helps. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3731. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.